Good day, fans of finales of Folly. I'm Unsilent, and we're back with the finale of Tomb Raider Anniversary. We're already into a cutscene, which is better than being ambushed at the start of a level for once. Oh, I say that and I take it back, because that looks big and boss-like. Well, I guess we know how the video is ending with Natla ambushing us from that giant sack there.
To the top, Lara. There's nowhere left to go but down.
I don't know, I feel like this game's beaten me down the whole time, Natla, so, I mean, really.
In the army of Atlantis,
this pyramid breeds far more than the soldiers you've faced.
Such as?
I now have the means to create anything I desire.
What is
like new henchmen?
Natla?
Ooh, that's a good question.
Three to rule. Tihokan and Qualopec were too weak to destroy what stands in the way of the Seventh Age.
Still don't know what the Seventh Age is.
Have the strength to claim this seat beside me.
Ooh.
Mortality has its price.
Such as?
What are a few lives to sacrifice for your dreams?
This is madness.
No, this is Sparta! Kick her into the lava pit.
Your life are within the Skion. Everything you've done has led you to this place. You're here because you belong here, Lara.
It's a good offer, Lara. You should take it under consideration.
That's who you are.
Oh, now this. I was complaining about the cutscenes a couple episodes ago, but this existential crisis, Lara? What am I really? This is a good cutscene. Ooh. I should have seen that coming.
No!
Oh my god, we are! This is Spartaing! We really did this as Sparta her into the pit of lava! Holy crap! Yeah. And so ends Tomb Raider Anniversary! Thanks very much for joining me as we journey through old games, this time with Tomb Raider Anniversary. Oh, balls, this doesn't look good. Oh, what the shit? Have we gone full Final Fantasy on this shit? Oh, there's the name of the level. Final Conflict. Oh, crap. Crap, 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 crap. What happened? Like, did it? What the fuck? What is going on? Alright, this is interesting. Okay, I don't know what the hell that is. This is a rather interesting boss fight. I don't quite know what is happening here. No. Okay, that went, I guess, reasonable. Okay, I think I was supposed to shoot its hand, but apparently whatever I was doing to shoot its hand did not exactly... Oh, I rolled off the ledge and died. All right, that was weird. That was bizarre. And we've reached the final conflict. I just left it like... Okay, I guess that's not really going to do much. Now, did it roll off? Yes, it did. Rolled off that time. All right, so I think that's, like, stage one of the fight. Okay, I shot its hand off. Awesome! Oh, no, it kind of caught me on the reach around. Not the best choice of words I could have ever done there. Okay, I think I got a... No. Caught me on the sweep there again. Oh, that was weird. That's the first time I've ever had a glitch out like that. Okay, I'm not entirely sure what is happening right now. Except that the game quite hates me. Let's just keep shooting, and hopefully... Nope, that didn't work. I thought that that was going to... Well, it pulled its stump out, so I mean, that's... a thing. Alright. Oh, we've shot its hand off completely. That should help expedite whatever the hell it is we're trying to do with it. Let's just keep shooting it until it falls off. I'm hoping that that helps. There we go. That took it off, and that should kill it. Well, that was a little longer than I thought it was going to take. Holy balls. All right. Well, no, that's not the end of the episode either. I thought, oh, well, that's the end of the episode. Thanks very much for joining me. We Final Fantasy. When I say they Final Fantasy the final boss, you ever notice how a lot of times, not always, but a lot of times, sometimes. Okay, maybe I'm just overgeneralizing from what I know of Final Fantasy IX. I don't know, like, I mean, if you've been watching the Final Fantasy Let's Play, one, if you haven't, what's wrong with you? But two, if you have, I haven't made it to the end of the game. But what I do know is that Final Fantasy IX is supposed to have the worst final boss in the history of Final Fantasy. And apparently what a lot of that has to come down to is the fact that oh, balls. Now is not the time, game. Now is not the time. Apparently, a lot of what that comes down to is the fact that Final Fantasy IX's, like, final boss is just sort of thrown in there out of nowhere and doesn't really tie into the game's story at all. Oh, that stopped moving. Alright, leap and lunge and we got it. Alright. So yeah, no one was particularly happy with the final boss of Final Fantasy IX because it didn't really tie into the story. It was just sort of a tacked-on annoying final boss fight. I'm sure there's a tricky way to get up. Ah! B for Big Med Pack! Unfortunately, I didn't have anything to shoot it with. Oh, there we got it. That was an unexpected centaur. But we got through that into a checkpoint. So yeah, we'll once I actually, you know, get to the final boss of Final Fantasy IX, that's probably not till like hell if I get to it before 2018, I'll be shocked. Alright, that switch. Okay, that lets us in there. Alright. Oh no. We'll shoot it with the submachine gun ammo. And now we'll move on into the... Okay, well... Oh! I've just been ambushed. Oh no, oh no, I'm... Now I'm pigeonholed in there, but I've got out. Oh, no, never mind, I'm in the water. Ollie, ollie, oxen freeze. Is that the phrase I am looking for? No, come on. You could use a few invulnerability frames in this game, let's be honest. Since it doesn't let you spam anything. I'm guessing there's something on the other side of those rocks, because there wouldn't be those rocks if they weren't important. But, I'm looking for something here. Well, you know what? In this game, water... Oh, something's got to move those. In this game, water usually hides something important, like a switch. All right, and let's flip the switch. What do we get? That thing. All right. Now let's see what that leads to then. I'm assuming it's probably not on a timer because it's out underwater. Oh, fuck you. I'm just going. All right. We're going to push this out of the way because this seems important. Oh, hi. Are you actually coming up here or are you just gonna... Ah, headshot. Actually, I have a vague idea of what it might want me to do with this. I have to bring it over here, climb up here, and go all the way around. I've got a ticket for the long way round, 2 bottle of whiskey, blah blah blah. Oh, just kiss my ass. You know, that's what I think of you. Is this, oh, there's a thingy there. Can I actually get through and jump to... Oh, no. No? Alright, back up. I can make that jump, no problem. See? Alright, we got whatever that was. Oh, we're just gonna have to climb back up here. Does this switch do anything? Opens that door. Does it close the other door? No. But what I was thinking was, what we have to do... If you drop down to there, Lara, thank you. Gotta jump there. Jump back, wall run, onto that, in center frame, just above Lara's head, and then up there, and then we'll figure out... Now we're just going to hustle across. Is that a thing there? Yeah. Okay, I was thinking, oh, crap. Now we'll jump across to here, grab that. Whoa, that was close. Jump up to here. Pick up whatever this ammo is. At this point, oh, I've got enough shotgun shells. Oh, and now I'm on the other side of that wall. Not much to work with here, though. Oh, I pull that down and I get it. Okay, so I need to find more that look like this. Oh, like that one right across there and that one right over there. Okay, I get it. So these are supposed to be... So these are shrouds covering whatever switches that we need to, and I need to get a third one. Okay. Well, except for the part where... Oh, B for Big Ben Pack! Holy balls! We're stun locked! Nope. Well, that got him. V for Small Med Pack. Alright, and that's all of them? Does that look like a straight through tunnel to you? That's a checkpoint, so I'd say that's a good sign. Alright! So we'll dive and go through this way. We'll see what we've got here. We'll pick up... I think that was a Small Med Pack. As we'll carry on through here. And we'll surface. I'm still trying to figure out what the final conflict here is, because if it's making me go through all this, then the final conflict obviously wasn't whatever the hell that... What the hell? Okay, I think I'm going back across that way. Oh, there we go. Ah, balls. There's some timing to that, I guess. Okay, that's a little trickier than I was expecting, so let's hope that I didn't lose too much time to the checkpoint. Alright, there we go. Let's wait for that. I think whatever I did here was the wrong move. Whatever I just did... I honestly don't know where to go from here, but whatever I do is probably not a smart idea. Oh wait, I think I have an idea. Nope, that was a bad idea. Alright. Can I get a checkpoint? Maybe, perhaps. That would be lovely. Alright, well, never mind. We'll just make do with what we've got. Whoa! Hey! Fuck! Nor the one that controls how far I launch. I actually have no control over how far I launch after that, because trust me, how many times have I tried that? No, you don't get to try that bullshit with me. But I don't get a checkpoint for that. Do I get a checkpoint now? Jeez, come on. Do I get a checkpoint here? There we go. Now, was that so hard, game? It is actively, if it's not trying to kill me in the game, it is trying to kill me IRL. I am fairly certain of that. Now. What? Oh, look.
Thousands of years I've waited for this moment. Do you realize what you've done?
Moderately foiled your plans, I'm guessing, since you're not dead.
Blood on your hands. Do you believe it was spilled for the good of all man? Or for your own selfish desire?
All that blood on your hands is literally just one person, because your hired goons... Oh, she just engaged warp speed. What the hell? Now, Miss Natla, your hired goons did... do most of their own... to your hired goons... the guy who was in Tosh in StarCraft 2, and then you have John Cena there. See, they took care of themselves. I should really be fair to John Cena, since he has gotten better since when he, you know, thought he was black. So let's say Justin Bieber there. You know, they... You know, they did kill each other. So So, I mean, you can't really say that Lara has a lot of blood on her hands, since it's only really Larson's blood that's on her hands. Now, I'm just kind of shooting at whatever I can get my hands on here. Oh, no. That was... See, when it forks like that, it does go around you, right? So you don't have to really worry about dodging. It's an interesting little... And when she shoots one beam like that, those ones like that, you can... Oh, we've clipped her wings! Ah! Oh, that looks important. Shoot it. Shoot the glowing thing on her back! That's the glowing thing is always important in boss fights. And Ned, I'm wounding you. You're... Actually, have you seen the little... that? It literally says, I have infinite bullets. Now, I can Oops, that was a mistake. B for big med pack, because I think I need it. Now, granted, I am using the cheap... and cheer... Oh, that was a mistake. I was going to say, I am using the cheap and cheerful... standard hand pistol, but I do have... Where'd you go? I do have this thing I can use. Oh, man. She's tightened up her spread on the... Oh, boy. Now I'm overthinking it. Now my problem is I'm just thinking too much. I mean, literally nobody's ever said that about me ever. But, I mean... I think that did something. I honestly don't know. Like, I mean, I'm shooting her, but I mean... Okay, B for big med packs, since I'm not entirely sure what the hell's going on. She's still getting me, and I mean, I'm just not entirely sure I understand the... Oh, wait, that didn't damage me. Wait a minute. Oh, it's not how... when I'm doing it. It's which direction am I doing it in. Oh, clever. Because I don't have to. It's not about dodging around her for it. It's about dodging in a direction. I have to dodge over her so I can see the jewel thing. Well, that's clever game. Like that. That's what I want to do. That was the wrong direction. Like that. That's what I want to do. And stun her. Ah, that's clever. Oh my goodness. Okay, that's clever. That, I will readily admit, is an incredibly clever done mechanic. I gotta give points to whoever thought that one up. I mean, it takes a little while for me to figure it out, but... But that was... Ooh, close. Oh my god, did I just find a reload button? With like... I was gonna say, did I find the reload button with like... B for big med pack? Well, I mean, I don't need them anymore, right? Logically, this is the conclusion of the game. This is logically the final boss fight, the final conflict, as it were. I mean, if I wanted to be a little punnier, I would say the final countdown. Oops, that was a mistake. I was just getting cocky there. Alright, there we go. Now, you just gotta... All right, just pick up all of the reloads you can, Lara. All right, there we go. Now that we're reloaded, now we're going to try and piss her off with just the pistols. Oh, now she's varied up her attacks again. So now the split attacks have three projectiles, but there's one coming up the middle, right? Okay, we missed that one. And we'll just shoot her in the back, and hopefully that'll... GG it, GG! Oh, nope, maybe not. Oh, we've got a quick time event, shit! Everybody look lively! Alright, now how are you gonna do it?
Nothing but a temporary stay of execution for your kind.
Ah, see, seventh, I told you, seventh age was the apocalypse.
Atlantis. I will find another. But you, you have lost everything.
That's usually, gloating's usually a sign that you're about to die, so. We shoot her in the eye. Oh, we're going to... You're immortal, except... stone.
I have it.
Now, please don't let there be a goofy platforming section at this point, and we just kind of cutscene our way out of this game. I think we hopefully have. Oh, there she goes. Well, that's erupting a little bit. But Lara has made her way to Natla's boat. Hope they left the keys in the ignition. They have. And now is the slowest getaway from an exploding island you've ever seen. Oh, it's raining down in front of us. Drive faster, Nettie! I can't! It's a geo! Oh, I guess she doesn't really have to... That's out of focus. I was gonna say, I guess she doesn't really have to worry too much about getting away. I guess the explosion's gonna be contained to the island. And, Lara pilots herself off into the sunset, and I guess that's the game? Indeed it is! It only took me nearly 9 hours of game time, and you probably saw a lot less of that than that on the channel. So that concludes the level. Look at all the fun stuff we've unlocked. So, that ends Tomb Raider Anniversary. So, as I am wont to do as we wrap up these games, little look back, a little review, and oh boy, oh boy, oh boy. It's another game where controls have let it down. I mean, the controls have dated badly because you've got these, you know, pre-DualShock PS, you know, dual analog PS1 controls that they've carried over from the original Tomb Raider, and it suffers for it. You have to remember, and I've mentioned this time and time again, the same year that Tomb Raider Anniversary came out, Uncharted 1 came out. And it's not a subjective thing. Uncharted 1 is a hell of a lot better than Tomb Raider Anniversary. I mean, just because you're remastering a game doesn't mean that you can't, you know, change bits and pieces. You could have, like, a classic control scheme and a modern control scheme if you really wanted. Like, when you put this on PS3, did you tell people, no, you can't use your two damn thumbsticks, you can only use the one? Did you even let them use the one? It's those things, right? Controls, they're important, you know? Until you go back and play these old games, you don't really realize how good we have it now. Are games really that much easier now? Maybe. But is it that we have better controllers now, and better controls now than we did, you know, 10, 20 years ago? That's an important thing that have we forgotten? Yes, probably. Because you look at how many people liked, you know, Shadows of the Empire. But, you know, if you were to release that game now, I don't rate your chances of it doing too well, but... But it's important to note that they have learned. The last two Tomb Raiders, Tomb Raider 2013 and Tomb Raider, Rise of the Tomb Raider, that was it. Those two games are much more, they've taken a lot more out of Uncharted's books. And they've done a very good job. I mean, they haven't quite gotten the story down. They're kind of okay with Lara now, but I mean, the rest of the characters and the rest of the story is kind of like, meh. But they've kind of figured out the gameplay relative to Uncharted. Is it a better game to play than Uncharted now? Rise of the Tomb Raider versus Uncharted 4. I don't know. I would compare Rise of the Tomb Raider's gameplay to Uncharted 3. I don't think that it was a... Uncharted 4 was a harder game to play than Rise of the Tomb Raider. Actually, no, Uncharted 2. I would say about as Rise of the Tomb Raider is about as difficult as Uncharted 2. Uncharted 4 was the most difficult of the game because the AI was a lot smarter, and then you had the emphasis on your positioning and stealth, which was a big change from previous Uncharted games. But I mean, at a certain point, like, it was still important right to the very end, but at a certain point in Rise of the Tomb Raider, stealth didn't matter. Once you've, you know, got your first automatic weapon, stealth, you know, didn't matter anymore. So, and here, like, here, I was going to say, the big difference here is, how many humans did you kill in this game? One. Larson. That was it. So, I mean, the emphasis on, oh, you've got blood on your hands, no. Because it was literally one person. So I guess this is another case of a Tomb Raider game kind of missing the mark on story. Lara's chasing the Skion because she has all her life, and that's the story. A lot of blanks, a lot of questionable motivations, unclear motivations. Let's be a little more fair. A little unclear motivations, and you know what? It hurts the game. Like, it's not aged particularly well. Not 10 years, not the 11 years before that either. You know, that's the thing about games. A lot of people love old games. Some games have aged really well. You look at, like, the classics have aged spectacularly. Your Marios, your Zeldas, your Final Fantasies, your... If I was to go back and play all-timer games like Myst and, like, Dungeon Keeper and, like, the old CRPGs from BioWare based on Dungeons & Dragons, games like that that are, like, considered all-time greats, aren't going to suffer from these same issues. Anyway, I think that will do it for the final episode of Tomb Raider Anniversary. Thanks very much for joining me as we've journeyed through this classic Tomb Raider game, Tomb Raider Anniversary. We'll be back next week, next Thursday with a new game. Next Tuesday, it's more Final Fantasy IX. But until then, like the video if you liked it, subscribe if you're new, and that'll help you catch up on old Tomb Raider Anniversary episodes and whatever we've done in the past and will be coming up in the future. Share on social media, subscribe on social media. These social media links are in the description below. At Unsilent On Air is the handle for Facebook and Tumblr and Twitter and Instagram. So until the next time, I'm Unsilent. Thanks very much for joining me. We'll see you with a new game next weekend. And until then, we will see you next time.